Welcome guys, all the YouTube and Twitch primers, they get you a spam noted. Today in this video, I'm gonna cover the live server, Pinnacle breakdown, and all the possible build that is viable right now. Okay, for the control glaber, there was no change at all. So you can like, you know, refer to my previous control video, or like if some like meta like change happens, then I will make another video later. So first of all, what got changed compared to PTR, guys? There was a nerf that happened on Pinnacle, only on Pinnacle. Thrust of Destruction got 10% damage nerf from a tripod. And Starfall Pounce got 20% damage nerf from the tripod. Red Dragon Horn, 5% damage nerf. So these are from here, if you see. So skill, and if you see here, thrust from this tripod, 10% nerf. Starfall Pounce from this one, 20% nerf. Red Dragon Horn from this one, 5% nerf. Clear, right? And something more happened is that identity 5% of attack speed and movement speed got nerfed, guys. This is very, very huge. Yeah, honestly, like these three, like, I mean, that's also a big nerf, but like, it doesn't matter. Compared to before patching the live server, her damage is 20 to 30% stronger than before the patch, even after this 8% nerf. Anyways, developers comment. We don't want Pinnacle's build to be fixed on spec crit entropy build. Also, that spec crit entropy is doing too much unintended damage. So what they did is they increased the risk that made a path for like multiple builds for like spec swift or spec swift crit, so on and so forth. Yeah, more kinds of combat stat distribution is now viable, but most likely the gear set will still stay as entropy, guys. So number one is spec crit. It's entropy 3-4. Engraving, Pinnacle, Grudge, Raid Captain, Ambush Master, Curse Door, and Adrenaline 1. So the least crit amount of this build becomes crit stat, you get 22. Entropy level 3 gives you 22. If it's level 2, you get 20, right? Back attack gives you 10%, adrenaline level 1, 5, shackling 20 gives 20 now, so that's 80% damage, at least, guys. And crit of the major skills, Half Moon 80%, Red Dragon, Starfall, they're all 80% within the shackling blue dragon, guys, within. Thrust and Forehead are 100%, Raging Dragon is 85%, these are used without the shackling dragon, guys, shackling blue dragon. Yeah, so pretty high, right? In average, the crit rate is really, really high. So what happens to the attack and the movement speed? Attack speed, movement speed. Identity now gives you 15 instead of 20 because of the nerf. Swamp gives you 12% at level 3. If it's level 2, it gives 10%, right? Your swift stat is not zero, like you have some swift like this, right? And this gives you like 1%, guys. Yeah, so 1%, that's 128%. And the raid captain only increases 12.6% damage. Do you guys remember last time in the video that I told you that King Blunt is mostly not viable on this build anymore? Because why, chat? Why? Your crit rate being at least 80% and your crit damage, guys, becomes 325 in this build. Yeah, I'll tell you the reason why. But anyways, with that, you know, kind of figures, the King Blunt does only 12% damage increase. Wait, but Memorizer, does that mean since Raid Captain only, you know, increases 12.6 now, but King Blunt is 12%, does that mean I can run King Blunt over Raid Captain? Why are people happy? The answer is, like, you know, most likely no, guys. Yeah, spam Keck W. I will tell you the reason a bit later. So, the characteristic of this build, chat, what is it? Highest one rotation DPS, and this is what actually matters a lot in KR. Yeah, and the reason is because this. In KR, like, the meta is burst, guys. Fitting every skills in Atrophin and in, you know, supporters like three bubble kind of things. That is why one rotation having the high DPS is actually what matters than the actual DPS in the Trixion. Spam noted. So it has the highest ceiling of the damage. Now, the possible questions, guys. Possible questions. Is King Blunt weapon viable? No. Raid Captain still has higher ceiling. What do you mean by higher ceiling? Watch, guys. So, this build has 80% crit rate and 325% crit damage. How? 65 from level 3 entropy crit damage, and 60 from the identity buff. So that's 325. Makes sense, right? And with this kind of like figures, your Kim Blunt damage increase is only 12%. If you have 90% crit, it's 12.6%, which is same to a raid captain. If even though like all your skills guarantee crits, then it's still like 13.1% damage increase. That is so, that skill so low, guys, so low. Meanwhile, raid captain can easily reach the full efficiency 18% from 12.6 by getting any buff from the outer side, like outside from your spec. What are they? Drop of Aether, guys. If a supporter runs Drop of Aether and, you know, generates a wind ball, the wind orb that increases the movement speed, that literally increases your damage by 5.5%, chat, if you're running this build. That's crazy. Yeah. Rage Rune, guys. Rage Rune, like, you put it on Shackling Blue Dragon for the rotation. This also, like, immediately, you know, increases your efficiency to 18%. Yeah, if it procs. Atrophine increases the movement speed as well, not just the attack, right? And other movement party synergy. There are, like, you know, a lot of them, right? Like Loyal Companion, Sharpshooter, War Dancer, Deathblade, right, guys? So the scaling, guys, the scaling is actually, like, Raid Captain is way much better than Keen Blunt. That is why I would say it's not viable, to be honest. Yeah, just run like this. This will be the meta. Okay, another question. Mass increase over Curse Door, is it viable? Because of 5% attack speed and the movement speed nerf that happened in the identity, I do not recommend it at all. So Glaver is now a back attack class, and the back attacking with this 10% attack speed nerf is gonna make you really, really difficult in the reality, guys. Really, really difficult. I do not recommend it at all, guys. It's gonna decrease your DPS. All right, all out attack, is it viable? No, this one we already confirmed on the last video. Even with 5 holding skill set, guys, it did far less DPS than this build, guys. Yeah, don't run this. How about hallucination over entropy to increase Keen Blunt weapon efficiency and be free from the back attack? No, the set itself did really low damage, guys. The thing is, but memorize, I already have like Keen Blunt and like, you know, I'm kind of trapped. So changing accessory is pain. I know that, guys, like a lot of like, you know, price, right? So keep up with what you have for some days, guys. Yeah. Do not try to change it instantly. Okay, guys. Yeah, that's the only advice I can give you. This time, let me go over to the skills, guys, quickly. On Spiraling Spear, you run Quick Recharge Rune. And so Spiraling Spear just got a new tripod called, you know, shoulder tackle. It moves forward like that and then, like, you know, pierces. Watch again. Okay, I have something to talk about this new tripod. This is like literally GOAT. It's like greatest of all time tripod, and this Spiraling Spear became a god skill. Let me tell you why. So number one, now it moves forward, and which means you can use it as a movement skill in a red stance, like this. If you use spacebar and Spiraling Spear, you move double, like that. Yeah, or if you can also use Spiraling Spear to spacebar, like that. And another thing is that it's a combo skill, right? So you type one time and it moves forward, and second type it pierces like this. Because it's a combo attack, Quick Recharge is really a good rune on here, because Quick Recharge does not have an inner cooldown, guys, unlike Rage Rune and Conviction Judgment Rune. So it has a chance to proc on both of the combo, like 1, 2. It does, guys, which reduces your overall, like, you know, rotation much better, like increasing the DPS. And it's not over yet, guys. It's not over yet. This skill has a counter on the first combo and second combo. In reality, like, you can actually counter with this skill by being on the back. So let's say that you're on the backside like this because you're entropy, right? What you can do is that you spacebar and then move by using this first combo, and then use the second combo heading to the head part like this. Just like that. Just like that. Like, this kind of play is viable. Next one. Forehead Dragon. Forehead Dragon, 3-1-2. I mean, yeah, 3-1-2. And a Galewind. Thrust, you run 3-2-1. And 3, this one you don't need as level 5. Yeah, you're already capped at attack speed. Galewind. Starfall Pounce, Galewind, and 1-1-2. Yeah, this one changes to something trashy. So you go for this one that increases the stagger. Red Dragon Horn, you go Galewind, of course. 1-1-1. Yeah, this one increases the animation speed by a lot, so it's way better. And because of the, you know, the perfect zone, the size increase of the perfect zone box, see? Like, even though it's fast, it's really easy to land. Yeah, you don't go for this one because this one changed for, to something else. Yeah. And Half Moon Slash, 1-3-2, or you can go 1-3-1. Bleed Rune, by the way. Raging Dragon, 3-1-2, or you can also go like 3-3-2. Yeah, you run Galewind. So I dropped the Quick Recharge from here because now the since the Spiraling Spear is a combo attack right now, and you can use the Spiraling Spear at least 2 times in the red stance, right? So I think it's enough to proc the Quick Recharge. So I didn't need the necessity of the Quick Recharge running on here. So I changed it into Galewind because this skill, even though you're using the additional slash, it's still slow, guys, because of the loss of the attack speed on the identity. Spam noted. And here, Vault Kick, I'm running this. And this one, Wind Splitter. So remember that in the Spiraling Spear, I used to run this one in the PTR that gives you party synergy uptime. But since this is way much better, you need to get this synergy tripod from somewhere else other than the Shackling Blue Dragon. And this is the answer. Wind Splitter on the first tripod has that. And the duration time is even higher, like even longer than the Spiraling Spear. It's 10 seconds. Spiraling Spear is 7 seconds. You put this to level 4 to apply the party synergy. 8% damage on crit. Spam noted. Lastly, Shackling Blue Dragon, 3, the party synergy, 16 seconds, 3-1-1. So quick preparation is here, and you need this at level 5. Oh, by the way, here's what happened to the Shackling Blue Dragon's amulet. So this used to be quick preparation level 5, right? But it moved to here. Wait, but memorizer. So a level 5 tripod turned into level 1 cap. Did you get back your amulet? Level 5 amulet? Yes, I did, guys. I checked it yesterday. I did get it back. And I immediately used that guaranteed level 5 amulet to upgrade this one. Because this one, the cap is level 1 right now before the patch on your server, right? So this is the only, you know, part where you can use, I guess. So I used it immediately here. Rune, you run Rage Rune to get the raid, you know, raid captain efficiency. And this time, let me go to the gems. For the gems, you run attack gems on every, you know, 6 attack gems. Of course, Red Dragon Horn, Starfall Pounce, Forehead Dragon, Thrust, Raging Dragon, Half Moon Slash. For the cooldown, honestly, you just have to run only 3 red skills. See? Red Dragon, Thrust, and Starfall, guys. Where is it? Yeah. Only these 3. Others, I'm gonna show you on the rotation. You actually don't need it. Yeah, in my opinion. You actually don't need it. So anyways, let me show you the rotation, guys. Switch, stack Adrenaline, Party Synergy, Raging Dragon Slash, Party Synergy plus Self Crit, Half Moon, Red Dragon, Starfall, Thrust, Forehead, Spiraling Spear, and then wait for the cooldown of the Spiraling Spear, and then use it and swap it when the Red Dragon Horn reaches 5 seconds. Yeah, Wind Splitter, Synergy, Raging Dragon Slash, Shackling Blue to Half Moon, and then keep on going. The rotation is quite simple. Just like that. Yeah, so the key is using the Spiraling Spear 2 times. And then swap to blue when the Red Dragon reaches 5. Just like this. Then the rotation is perfect. You swap, and the cooldown is already back. Most of the people, even in the invent, like, they are dropping the Conviction and Judgment, guys. And there's no reason to proc the Conviction Judgment for the Awakening, because Awakening's damage is, like, it's not that strong, since you run Entropy plus Ambush Master. You don't use it with the Shackling Blue Dragon, Because this skill is, you know, this skill already does similar damage to this, and when it's the timing of using Awakening, like this, and then you go to the major DPS cycle, and then after the first Spiraling Spear, you use it since everything's on cooldown. This is the perfect timing to use it, and then use it again, and then when it reaches 5, switch back. Party Synergy, Raging Dragon Slash, so on and so forth. So that was the first build, Spac Crit. And the second build I want to share is Spac Swift Crit. 1600, 550, and 350. Spac Swift Crit. Entropy 3-4. Necklace should have Spac Swift. Bracelet should have Spac Crit. And one ring as a crit. Period. Engraving. Same as the previous one. Pinnacle, Grudge, Raid Captain, Ambush Master, Crystal, Adrenaline 1. The least crit for this, because you don't run, you know, full spec crit, you get only 12%, you know, from the crit stat. Entropy level 3 gives you 22, back attack 10, Adrenaline level 1, 5, Shackling 20, so that's 10% lower than this previous one. Yeah, 10% lower, 70. So your major skills on the for the crit, Half Moon, Red Dragon, Starfall Pounce, even with Shackling, it's only 70%. Thrust, Forehead are 90 without Shackling. Raging is 75 without Shackling. And Attack Speed, Movement Speed becomes higher. See, you get Identity 15%, Swamp gives you 12% at level 3. Swift Stat, by having this much, you get 10%. And that's 137, by the way. The feast, guys, it's 3.5, right? So that adds to like, you know, exactly 140. Full efficiency on the Raid Captain, 18%. So what's the characteristic of this? No stats are getting wasted, guys. This is like kind of like a perfect distribution. And gets high gain from having a crit party synergy because your crit rate is low, guys. Yeah. And what else? It's really fast on the rotation because of the swiftness. It's actually pretty fast, and it's definitely cleaner than the previous one. So, the question, can I run Adrenaline level 3 over Crystal level 3 as a spec swift? Yeah, Entropy. Yes, in that case, go for Aether Predator level 1, guys. This becomes like completely another build, guys. Spec swift build. Yeah, so that's why like this is kind of like containing two builds, guys. If you run Adrenaline 3 over Crystal, in that case you run full spec, like spec 1800, guys. Spec 1800 and Swift like 650 kinda. DPS in Trixion is similar, chat. These two are similar when I tried it. Very similar in the Trixion, and both are a bit stronger than the spec crit in the Trixion, guys. Yeah, because in the Trixion, if you give like, you know, swiftness, it becomes more consistent than burst, right? And consistent classes actually do like kind of more DPS in the Trixion. But in the real raid, as I told you, this is what matters a lot. DPS of one rotation, guys. Yeah. So in the real raid, like this will have higher potential to do more damage than these. Let's go over to the skills and stuff. This is what you have to do. The only thing that changes, honestly, is this part, Wind Splitter. Because you have 550 swiftness, so you get like some over 10% cooldown, right? So because you have, you know, more cooldown, I mean more cooldown reduction, Shackling Blue Dragon can infinitely give the party synergy uptime of this 16 seconds, which means you do not need to use Wind Splitter. So you can lower this down and, you know, put the four stuff on somewhere else, yeah, like here, something like that. And if, by the way, if you don't have skill points, of course, like, you know, you can lower the some stuff from, like, you know, from these four, or like you can even lower the 12s to 10 of the weakest damage, you know, skills. This one, Raging Dragon, is the weakest, by the way. Others are all same. Rotation is same, skill, tripod, runes are all same. Even engraving was same. Gems are also same as well. So in this case, look how clean it becomes. Okay, from here. It's way much faster. Rotations are completely same. Wait for the Spiraling Spear. And then move when it's reaching, yeah, 5 seconds. Keep on moving like this. See? Yeah. So this is spec Swift Crit or a SPAC Swift. All right, next one, last one. SPAC Swift 1800-650, Nightmare 3-4. So there were a lot of people in the invent, like studying, because not just in the West, even in KR, there are people who dislikes the new playstyle of the Pinnacle, like getting forced into back attack. So there were a lot of people, you know, studying the Nightmare, and I also tried to refer to it, and I tried some of the stuff by myself as well, and this is what I came up with. Pinnacle, Grudge, Raid Captain, Keen Blunt or Ambush Master, and then Crystal and Adrenaline 1. The least amount of crit is you get crit stat, you have like 65 crit, right from here. Yeah, you get like 65, right? So that increases like 2%, guys. So 2% crit stat. Back, if you back attack, you get 10%. And Adrenaline level 1 gives you 5%. And Shackling gives 20%. So that's only 37% crit rate. Spam Keck W. Yeah, it's super low. So crit of the major skill becomes Half Moon, 37%. Raging Dragon becomes 100, because Raging Dragon has tripod to increase the crit rate, guys. I will show you on the you know, the skill, yeah, section. Thrust gives you 77, Forehead gives you 77. You have to use all these four skills in 6 seconds for the Shackling, guys, in the Shackling. And the skills that you don't have to run in a Shackling is Red Dragon, Starfall, you just use a guaranteed crit tripod. Attack speed, movement speed, like same, like 140% with the Feast, guys, you can reach. Okay, because you're running like 650 swiftness over 550, right? So characteristic, guys, Keen Blunt increases around only 13% damage overall, guys, overall. Yeah, that is why, like, I am also giving you a suggestion of running Ambush Master instead, chat. But then what's the problem if you run Ambush Master over Keen Blunt? Like, then what's the point of running Nightmare, guys? So even though it's a Nightmare, I don't think back attack is optional, guys. I don't think it's optional, because if you don't back attack, your crit rate becomes like 27 at the lowest. So this part, I think it should not have the parenthesis like this. It should be a mandatory. And another one, if you can do 60% of back attack, then entropy builds, all three entropy builds are stronger than this, guys. Yeah, let's go to the skills. Runes and skills like are pretty same tripod, except for the ones that I go, guys. I will go on the four skills that you run different tripod compared to other entropy. Half Moon. Okay, this one right here, this one you actually don't have to change it. You go 1-3-1 or 1-3-2. But the reason why I'm trying to make some, you know, explanation here is that this is a new tripod of the second one. At level 5, it increases 60% crit rate, guys. 60. Wait, Memorizer, then the crit rate of this can become from 37 to 97. Hey, yo, why are you not using this, but this one? So, I did the DPS test, and surprisingly, this did more damage, guys. This one, which increases 96% damage, did more damage than 60% crit rate increase, guys. It did, even with that low 37 crit rate. And I was kind of like, is this a bug or something? And I tried to figure out, refer to invent. Invent people came up with the same conclusion. So you go with this, guys, even on this build. You do not run this one. Yeah, you go with this one. 1-3-1 or 1-3-2, period. Okay, Raging Dragon Slash, this one, you do not run this one, the quick preparation. You run the crit tripod. Yeah, you see the difference, right? Half Moon has something better in the same line, which is called this. But in Raging Dragon Slash, crit is better than quick preparation. That's why, like, for Raging Dragon Slash, it's better to run this. Increases 40%. That's why it can reach 100% crit rate, guys. 60 plus 40. Yeah, because this one, the third tripod gives you 25% as well, right? Okay, and the last two skills which have changes are definitely the Red Dragon Horn. You run this one right here, guarantee crit, and also here, you run guarantee crit here. Makes sense, right? Yeah, so that's the difference. And for the gems, aside these, you know, gems, you have to add one more gems, so it's even more expensive. You have to add Raging Dragon Slash cooldown gem. Yeah. Reason why you have to do that is because you're running the crit rate tripod over quick preparation, which reduces the cooldown. That is why you have to compensate this cooldown by running high level 10 gem. Yeah, period. For this last spot, you don't need anything. So let me show you the rotation. So how it goes is like this. You have to put half moon slash, raging dragon slash, thrust, and forehead. These four skills in the 6 seconds of the shackling blue dragon's 20% crit rate self buff. Skills that you don't have to put it are these two, which guarantees crit. So these two will be used at the end. Get the adrenaline stacks. Shackling. Half moon, and then change to this and forehead like this. And then, do you see that? The crit buff ended perfectly when the four-headed dragon starts to end. Let me show you one more time. So first, get the adrenaline stacks. Let's say shackling, half moon, raising to thrust, forehead. And then go on with the guaranteed crit skills. Yeah, like that's one rotation. And if you come back by using 2 times of Spiraling Spear, then skills will come back, keep on going like this. That's how it goes, yeah. And DPS, as I told you, like, if you can do 60%, at least 60% of back attack, just run Entropy. It's way, way much stronger, guys. Anyways, that was the end of this video. That took kind of long, right, guys? Yeah, hope you guys watch all of them because it is it's gonna be very, very helpful for you guys to, go for which one you want. And until the next video, stay GigaChad and spam noted. Thank you so much, guys. Come to Twitch.